I was circumcised at 18. After the circumcision, I felt nothing, no sensation at all. I knew something wasn't right, but I just thought if I waited, everything would go back to normal. So I waited. I was in denial for the longest time. One day, it hit me that this was not going to change. So I called the doctor up and told him how upset I was and didn't understand why I had no sensation or feeling left. It was nothing like it was before. He basically told me it was me and cut me off and said he has to go and not to call him again. After that, I got a receipt in the mail saying it's been paid for completely. I didn't pay for it at all. So what I think is they were scared I was going to take legal action, but I didn't know at the time I could or I would have. It was a very lonely time. People don't research it because they look up to doctors, and a lot of the doctors in America, just that's the first thing they suggest, the law circumcised. And just because they don't have it and they were sexually mutilated does not give them the right to do it to other people. The foreskin is what has all the sexual nerves to orgasm. They have the most sensitive nerves. It's like once you cut that, it's basically, that's why circumcised guys have to force it so hard to get an orgasm and an erection. They have to basically need a lot of lube and have to stroke it so hard back and forth. They knew this when they were doing it back, because they tried to prevent masturbation. It's basically the most sensitive part of the penis. 20 to 30,000 nerves in it. And without that, sex can never be the same. But most circumcised guys think what they have is normal, and it's completely not. And if you watch a circumcised guy intact, you could tell the difference in the facial expressions. That's all you have to look at, their facial expressions. I believe that it has a lot to do with why guys have so many issues too in this country, why they have to act so extreme, so butch or so feminine. They just don't know. In Europe, they're just relaxed. They're comfortable with their bodies in Europe. The guys in America really aren't, because how can they be when the most important part of the penis was taken from them? Maybe they don't want to believe it, but psychologically, they really, they have to know. So.